have found this enemy, if you are reading the word of God, and then after that, you don't have to stand anymore, but for the reading of the word, please stand. Amen. Oh, also, we want to get ready for our Christmas program. Amen. We need to get ready for our Christmas program so our young people would celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The time changed, and it seemed like everything just went crazy on this morning, but I believe that God is in this house. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All types of distractions, amen, have happened on today and yesterday, but we worked through yesterday, we're going to work through today. Amen.
Amen.
If you're ready to read the word of God, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. It says, then Jesus said to those Jews who believed in him, if you abide in my word, you are my disciple indeed, and you shall know the truth. Somebody said, know the truth. And the truth shall make you free.
Amen.
And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Amen.
Amen. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, we thank you today. We thank you for life, health, and strength. We thank you, God, for the activities of our limbs. And Father, we ask you, God, that you hide me behind the cross, that you may be glorified in this place. Father, we thank you that we come to celebrate you on today.
Yes.
We come thanking you on today. We come, Heavenly Father, knowing that you are in control of everything and every situation. And God, we come to give you glory on today.
Yes.
Father, it is in you that we live, move, and have our being on today. Now, God, serve the gift that is in me, Lord, that I may equip your people and your ambassadors of Christ, Lord, that you may get the glory in each and every one of our lives on today. We thank you. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Before we show you the clip, you may be seated in the presence of the living God. Amen. Let me preach again and just look at somebody and say, I am excited about your future. The reason why I keep having you to tell your neighbor, I'm excited about your future, because you never know if the person you sit next to have had any encouraging words.
Amen.
This week.
Amen.
We take for granted that people that we come in contact with, we take it for granted that they are motivated, that they will see another day. We take for granted that they are excited about life, but everybody that you come in contact with is not excited about life. And I want to equip the body of Christ to learn how to encourage one another.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
We're going to go to look at a clip called The Wiz. It is, The Wiz, it was made in 1978, I believe. A branch off of The Wizard of Oz, okay? But we're going to Manhattan, where we call it The Wiz. Amen? So I'm going to show you a clip of two little clips. Will last about 6 minutes, and then we will come back and talk more about The Wiz. When you talk about The Wiz on this week, I want you to understand that we are talking about having wisdom, the wisdom of God. We need to learn how to be more initiative, and we need to learn how to have the zeal for God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we are focusing on wisdom, we're focusing on having initiative, and we are focused on having a zeal for God. Amen?
Amen.
Brother Solomon, can you go ahead and play The Wiz?
Most important.
see nothing again. Night without moon or star. 경계시했다.
He was just there. up his power. God wants you to lift up his energy. God wants you to lift up his word. God wants you to lift up his purpose. Because everything you do should be for Christ.
Amen.
Now, he's handling me up in here. Everything you should do should be for Christ. So a life-changing encounter. God had a responsibility. Now we know the characteristics of God, right? I mean, the characteristics of the scarecrow. I'm sorry. The characteristics of the scarecrow.
Amen.
The wizard, he was looking for the wizard. He needed the brain. But this messed me up. He needed the brain, but he could talk. He needed a brain, but he was already thinking. Y'all ain't saying that, y'all missing it. He needed a brain, but he was already conversating. Y'all ain't saying that. So sometimes people don't even know what you have. Look at somebody say, people know the power that you have. Oh God, y'all gonna hurt me today. Y'all gonna hurt me today. Y'all gonna hurt me today. Y'all know I'm laughing. So come on. I hope y'all know I'm already laughing. Look. God wants to know, are you gonna use what you already have? Stop measuring yourself to other people. God wants to know that you do have a brain. Because he said, you gotta do like the word of God said, created me a clean heart and renew the right spirit within me. You gotta let God transform your first the kingdom of God.
Yeah, yeah.
Y'all gonna make me pull these glasses off in a minute. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Y'all know I got gifts. I'm trying to be cute today. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you.
Amen.
Let me cite one real quick. Y'all make James blush because I know when y'all sung to them, he turned red. Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait. No, I'm just kidding. It's just fun to be in the house of God and you can enjoy one another's company. Amen. People are coming through the door. You don't know what they're dealing with. People are coming through the door and they come to get a word from the Lord. And I come to encourage somebody today because you got more going for you than you think that you do. Don't let things and setbacks hold you back. God allows a storm in your life to get you to a different place in your life. And when he gets you in a different place in your life, you got to see, God, what is the purpose of me being here? The first person she ran into, Dothan ran into, was an old scarecrow that have already learned the crow's anthem. You can't win, child. You can't get out. You can't get out of the game. And then he said, people say that I can get out. He said, but the things just stay the same. People tell us we can get out, but things stay the same. So how do we get people out without and getting them to understand that things don't have to stay the same? First of all, you got to help them stop making excuses.
Amen.
Oh God, y'all ain't gonna pray with me today. You got to help them stop making excuses. So here it is. Y'all gotta bear with me because I'm reading my notes from my cell phone. The enemy had deleted my notes. But God is gonna get a word today, amen?
Amen.
And I don't even know how to work this phone, but it's all right. But look here. Now here, what did the scarecrow need? He needed a brain. He needed a brain, and so now God didn't let him make excuses. We got to get to the wizard. I need you to understand, we can't keep making excuses. You got to get to the wizard. You got to get to the word. You got to understand. You say the Bible says, if any man lack of wisdom, let it ask of God and give it to every man liberally and upbraid it not. You got to understand, when God have already made a way out, so all you got to do is seek God for the way out. I will not put no more on you than you can bear. I never forget the days, one of the darkest days of my life. They said, one day we kept having children after children, and all of a sudden I kept hearing what everybody else was saying. Well, you need to stop having these children. You need to do change it in camp. Let me explain. It's a life changes in camp. You come in contact with different people so you can help change their life.
Amen.
But you know what we do? We, instead of looking why I am assigned here, we look and measure ourselves to other people. God never told you that you had to run my race. Oh, that was good right there. Oh, God. And you know what we mess up at? When we put our kids in Little League football and stuff like that, we don't help them to have the balance to be competitive, but not measure yourself to the person you are assigned next to. Oh, God. It's a life changing encounter. Don't be coming in trying to make the scarecrow act like her. All I want to know is that when you fall down, what did you say? Get up. You ain't got to know a whole bunch of scriptures. All you have to do is just say, get up. Oh, God. You ain't got to come and pay my bills. All I need you to do is tell me to what?
Get up.
Yeah. Y'all feeling this now? All you have to do until you get the scriptures, can you tell me that Jesus, come on, there's power in his name.
Amen.
There's power in his name. Come on. There's power in his name. Come on. James, there's power in his name. Oh, Lord God. Baby, there's power in his name. If you can't remember anything else, you better teach them maybe how to call on Jesus. What's his name?
Jesus.
What's his name?
Jesus.
We got many other bands. What's his name?
Jesus.
Oh, God, he's a bright in the morning star. What's his name? Now, understand, Dorothy is you having an assignment. Because the scarecrow already came with excuses. Can you tell me, look at me, can you tell me that I can walk again? Can you tell me that I can dance again? Huh? Can you tell me that I can talk again?
Yeah.
Oh God. He stayed up there because he had nobody to encourage him.
Mm.
I want my toy in this church to learn how to encourage you so you can encourage yourself.
Yeah. Amen.
You can't encourage me if you can't learn how to encourage yourself.
Amen.
Come on. You can't have no pity party every day. Come on now. You can't go into depression every day. You got to be able to get yourself up and do my days in the same. He said, I had to learn how to encourage myself. Do you know how long David ran from Saul? He was already anointed as king. But what do you do when God anoints you as king and then sends you back to the pasture? You got to hold on to your testimony. Because there will be a life-changing encounter because Samuel is coming. Oh God, y'all gotta reach out by. Samuel is coming. And then you're gonna have a Jonathan in your life. They say, listen here, I'm not caught up in positions. Oh, that's the problem in the church. We're so caught up in positions that we don't want to help nobody. We caught up in positions because you need the title. I come to tell you today, you can have my title. All I want is Jesus. All I want to see is you healed. All I want to see is you delivered. All I want to see is you set free. You can have the title, but give me Jesus. is a life changer in Canada. Take me to Hosea 4 and 6. Let me tell you, show you why we're not making it. Hosea 4 and 6. The problem was with the scarecrow that is like many of us. He didn't need no brains. Y'all hear me? The scarecrow didn't need no brain. He needed wisdom. He needed an initiative. And he had to have a zeal to be out of the place that he had been dormant so long. How long have you been there? How long have you been in a place that you're not growing? How long are you going to struggle in that mindset? The Bible says, when you know the truth, John 8 and 32, when, I don't like the other version's way of putting it, because it says, when you know the truth will set you free. I don't like that. Because anything you will set in, set out of, you can be set right back in. I like the way the King James Version put it. He said, when you know the truth will make you free. Oh God. But something you just cannot go back to. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing up here. So let me take you to Hosea chapter 6. Hosea was all about his relationship and his relationship with God. Y'all know some of us couldn't handle what Hosea went through. We ain't gonna talk about that. Hosea had to go marry a woman. Hosea had to go marry a woman that was walking the streets. And then God said, love him anyway, love her anyway. What? Y'all complain. We complain, and God ain't really made you do nothing.
Amen.
God told him to go marry a woman that was a prostitute.
Yeah.
Say, I want you to love her like I love you. But look what Hosea 4 and 6 says. My people are destroyed for the lack of what? At first I used to think that I had to have a college degree. I ain't against it. But it ain't really that. It's that my people perish because they don't have the knowledge of my power. God said, my people perish because they don't know the power that you are talking about. Can I teach this? So here it is. He said, Hosea, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. He said, because you have rejected knowledge. He said, also will reject you from being preached for me. Here it is. It's to the leaders. Listen up, leaders. You want to be a leader? Some of you are afraid to be a leader. Listen, leaders. The problem was here is that the leaders was doing one thing over here and not giving the full knowledge of God over here. And they just had a form of godliness. So the people was perishing because they was confused on the lifestyle that the leaders lead. Oh God. So he says, because you have forgotten the laws of God, he says, I also will forgive your children. That messed me up. Don't forgive the children. Oh God, it got personal then, because now it's not about everybody else's kids. He said, I'm going to forgive your children. You have a responsibility. Look what he did. Here he is. He said, the more they increase, the more they sin against me. Some of us hadn't got the promotion you want is because you are not ready for the promotion. What are you going to do when God gives you the promotion that you need? Now that you get an increase, how are you going to handle the increase? You're going to buy another house. You're going to get you another car. It's okay, he wants you to do that. But he don't want you to get the car and you can't pick nobody up. So-and-so, can you come out and bring me to church? You got some gas money? I'm tired of picking them up. Every time I look up, they want some. But when you're doing it to God, God will tell you when to draw the limits. He says,
Amen.
The more they sin against me, he said, I will change their glory. I will change their glory to shame. Mm-hmm. You have a responsibility. And every week we want to talk about, first she came and encountered with the scarecrow. They couldn't think and didn't know that he had the power that he had. He had to learn how to dance again. He had to learn how to talk. He was already talking, but he wasn't talking the right language. He thought he had to get, he didn't know nothing about the wizards. There are people you come in contact with, you don't know nothing, they don't know nothing about your God.
Amen.
How many people in your job know about the God that you serve?
Amen.
Huh? How many people in your family know about the God you serve? How many of your neighbors know that you serve a true and living God?
Amen.
And so God says, since you are not being responsible with the assignment that I gave you, you can't put this assignment all on me. I'm doing my assignment. Or you going to do your assignment.
Amen.
Or you going to keep giving excuses. I don't have a brain. My people perish for the lack of knowledge. He said, here the Pharisees kept coming against Jesus, trying to trip him up instead of him getting the knowledge from Jesus. Every time he looked up, before we got to the part about the truth, there was a woman that they had caught in adultery. And everybody was pointing out her sin. Everybody was ready to stone her. I love the way Jesus handled things. Oh God, he was wonderful. he was so wise. He knew how to take initiative. He knew how to do it without making you feel bad. Well, he did make them feel bad. But he had a zeal for his assignment. He had to get to that cross so you don't have to stay on the cross.
Amen.
He had to get to the cross so you can live again. You're supposed to live. You're supposed to live in victory every day.
Amen.
So where is your mind? Where is your mindset? My people perish for the lack of knowledge. Because you're not doing your assignment, somebody perishing. And now it don't even bother you no more that you're not working your assignment. My people perish because you have a responsibility. And he said, now you're increasing. He said, but I'm going to make your glory turn to shame. And if you don't do it for yourself, do it for your children.
Amen.
So I come to ask you today, are you living like the crow, the scarecrow? Are you reciting all the negative conversations around you? What anthem are you singing? What are you... Y'all give me some soft music. What anthem are you singing? It wasn't that the scarecrow really needed a brain. What he needed was the truth. And when you know the truth will make you free. You need to know that God have your best interest in mind.
Yes.
God will make it, sometimes he will let you get to your weakest point so he can prove his point.
Yeah.
He could have gave Abraham a child before he turned 99. He could have gave him a child. He could have, look how long Abraham had to wait for the promise to come to pass. We have this microwave faith now that we want everything right away. But sometimes you're just going to have to keep pressing. Sometimes you're just going to have to keep pushing. Sometimes you have to push until something happens. Do you believe that God is still going to do what he said he's going to do in your life?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Do you believe that God is able to honor his word in your life?
Amen.
You can tell me you'll take my word, but you won't take God's word? Study to show thyself approved unto God. Saints, we have a lot of work to do. There are so many souls that need to be saved out here.
Amen.
And when they won't listen, he says, shake the dust off your feet and move to the next person. Move. Move. Don't stay on the pole. Keep making excuses. Don't stay around the negative conversations. You have to know that God is able. Anybody believe that God is able?
Amen.
Do you believe that God is able? Do you believe that God is still going to honor his word? Do you believe that God still will do what he said he's going to do? God said, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. He had to break Paul down. And Paul said, I learned how to abase and I learned how to abound. He said, whatever state I am in, God, he said, I'm going to go after you. I don't know about you, but I am a God chaser.
Amen.
Because He may have forgotten my name.
Yes.
I know y'all tired of hearing about it. He may have forgotten my mother's name someday. But there was one name.
Yes.
Oh, y'all ain't saying that right here.
Yes.
Y'all ain't saying nothing to me. There is one name that he cannot forget.
Yes.
He never forgot the songs he knew about his name.
Yes. Come on, give the Lord some glory. Come on, give us some praise.